Who am I? I am a cheater. I cheat you out of contentment because you deserve better than this. I cheat you of knowledge because you already know it all. I cheat you of healing because you are too full of me to forgive. I cheat you of right living because you refuse to admit when you are wrong. I cheat you of your dreams because you would rather look in a mirror than out of a window. I cheat you of genuine friendship because nobody is gonna know the real you. I cheat you of love because real romance demands sacrifice. I cheat you of God's greatness because I convince you to seek your own greatness. You like me because you think I'm always looking out for you. How untrue. I am looking to make a fool of you. Who am I? I am pride.
I cheat you from your God-given destiny because you demand your own way. I cheat you of contentment because you deserve better than this. I cheat you of knowledge because you already know it all. I cheat you of healing because you are too full of yourself to forgive. I cheat you of holiness because you refuse to admit when you are wrong. I cheat you of vision because you'd rather look in a mirror than out of a window. I cheat you of genuine friendship because nobody is going to know the real you. I cheat you of love because real romance demands sacrifice. I cheat you of greatness in heaven because you refuse to wash others' feet on earth. I cheat you of God's glory because I convince you to seek your own glory. My name is Pride. I'm a cheater. You like me because you think I'm always looking out for you. Untrue. I'm looking to make a fool of you. God has so much for you. I admit, but don't worry. If you stick with me, you'll never know. Pride is like bad breath. Everybody else knows you got it, but you don't. How can we identify pride in our life? Does anybody want to know? Say that again. All right. Or Chachi Moses, that sometimes through no aminga to detect pride. Everybody else around us can see it. Everybody else knows it. But pride also does something. It blinds us from the truth. How can you identify pride when you always focus on others' faults? You're prideful. When you must prove that you're always right, you're prideful. When you look down on others, you're prideful. When you must maintain control of everything, you're prideful. When you must have your way in every situation, you're prideful. When you're quick to blame others for everything wrong, you're prideful. When you're self-righteous, when your sin is better than everybody else's sin, you're prideful. When you must be first, you're prideful. When you're very competitive, you're prideful. When you desire to be served, you're prideful. When you get angry very easily, you're prideful. When you will never admit that you're wrong.
Am I talking to anybody today? Steve, where am I wrong? Did you ever catch me?
When you have a difficult time to forgive others.
You're wrong. When?
That's it. Say it.
See, you can't even come out of it, so that means I'm right. No, that's
it. There's not a lot of things that God hates. I will promise you, Odell Motol, I hate. There's not a lot of things. But look at this verse of scripture. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 13 says this. All who fear the Lord will hate evil. Therefore, I hate pride and arrogance. God hates pride and arrogance. Say that with me. God hates pride. God hates pride. Why does God hate pride? Because a prideful manus feels he's independent. He does not rely on God, but he relies on himself. Et manuf kaisa self-centered is prideful, and God hates self-centeredness. Because of pride, we separate ourselves from God. We separate ourselves from the hand of God. We separate ourselves from the blessings of God. We separate ourselves from the power of God. Odell Pinda, I reject the proud. Naitu kanchi le devlesa kanasutu pride ane chotrayo. Pride ane choyilo. God will not have anything to do with pride. But he also says this. I give grace to the humble. I give grace to the humble. Come on, let me see some hands. Who needs some grace today? Grace comes through our humility. By humbling ourselves, I prinjaraz. So de trubula menodil. Antunchilazo grace le devlesco. All sin. I don't care what sin you think it is. Whatever sin you could come up with, any sin you could conjure up in your brain. The root of it is pride. The root of sin is pride. Upsada Jimmy. Because sin is about satisfying self. Is that true? Yes or no? Come on, talk to me. Is sin about satisfying self? So anytime you want to do your will and you want to satisfy yourself, and that's a sin. Well, that is rooted from pride. And wherever we see pride in Scripture, God did he cause pride on the Bible, we see destruction. Pride goes before destruction, a haughty spirit before a fall. Wherever there's pride in Scripture, wherever people were full of pride, destruction was sure to come. The Tower of Babel. Sabu ka janaw zo story. Galev azine ka ko tower. Audel avilomas ka lende in. God confused their language. You guys know the story, right? But listen why. Dixo pending. Bildisardeo tower, and this was their words that they said. Let us make a name for ourselves. Their purpose for building the tower was tekaran pengo agnav. Te baran penga nava. That's why the tower was built. Let me share this with you today. Please listen. You were designed to lift the name of God. Amen. That's why God designed you. That is your purpose in life. Your purpose is to lift the name of God. Amen. Never ever to lift your name above the name of God. His name must be first and foremost in every one of our lives. King Saul started off very humble. Lashomanus. But after a while, because of some victories, because of some good things happening to him, Ibn Motol, he went and he built a monument to himself. Goloy Vazdak statue in his own image to glorify him. And what happened to Saul? Sazek Dernolak Logo, King Uzziah, who took over for his father. And when he started off great. The blessings of God was upon his life. 2 Chronicles chapter 26 verse 5 says this, he set himself to seek God in the days of Zechariah, who instructed him to fear the fear of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, ton sama, as long as he sought the Lord, God made him prosper. As long as Rodale Devles, as long as he submitted to God, as long as he sought direction from God, God made him prosper. My brothers and sisters, listen to what I'm telling you today. If you want to see the blessings of God on your life, you must submit to God. And you will prosper in every area of your life. But look what happens after a little while. 26:16. But when he had became powerful, he also became proud, which led to his downfall. He sinned against the Lord, his God, by entering the sanctuary of the Lord's temple and personally burning incense on the incense altar. He got to a point in his life that he felt proud. Because of his power, because of his victories, because of the good things that was happening in his life. Nazakono tejala camparato into the temple to burn offerings. Ferio rasai kodasas leskibuchi. And the Bible says when he went in and he did this, leprosy fell upon him. And he eventually died. Listen to what I'm telling you today. God never overlooks any of our pride. He don't care who you are. He don't care of your past accomplishments. He don't care how good you used to be. He don't care what you did in the past. When pride comes, you will be rejected by God. Why am I telling you this today? Asunen somotavtuminga, please. Our hearts and our minds and our lives needs to be guarded from pride. Oh, pride, sir, one of Satan's greatest tricks. Oh, dusmano yuzil pride ti peravelle devleska manus. Ai trubul te ara kazamen. Sostar, kame pachav. Kakobors, sete karalo del barabucha amensa. Me pachavka sit in the cas of Swunso Mosley Devlesko, or Bosui Mosley Devlesko, Ezor, I butara le Devleski. We're going to see the power of God move like we haven't seen before. We're going to see the blessings of God. We're going to see salvation. We're going to see healings. We're going to see miracles. And God is going to use the young men and the young people of this church. And God is going to move in a mighty way. Ara kantume, they not dealt pride under the marine. You must remember the source of all of this is God and God alone. And the Bible swako just to stay humble in the hands of God. Because if we stay humble in the hands of God, He will lift us up. Give Him glory. Isaiah chapter 14. Verses 13 and 14 says this. You said in your heart, I will ascend to heaven above the stars of God. I will set my throne on high. I will sit on the mount of the assembly in the far reaches of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will make myself like the Most High. Somebody tell me who's this talking about. It's the devil himself. I will. Oh, I will attitude. Avel straight kataro bing. Oh, I attitude comes directly from the pits of hell. Magaprala sunen somotav duming ajes. Trabulte arakazan en kataro I. A lot of people love to mention themselves in everything. I did this. I prayed. I preached. I fasted. I went. Da kosto aratur kataro duzmano. And if God threw Lucifer out of heaven, why do we think we can get away with it? Am I talking to anybody today? So we need to guard ourselves from pride. So do you want to know today how to defeat the giant of pride? Do you want to know? Come on, guys. Number one, serve others. Serve others. Servisar caber baracas. Toca ver baracas ang latuti. Toca ver baracas ang ukundo. Serve others. Mark chapter 10, verse 45 says this: For even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve others, and to give his life as a ransom for many. O Cristo, Shabli de Blesco, O Gaza, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Master of the universe, did not come to be served, but he came to serve others. Kako so attitude kataro cristiano. Kako so chacho attitude kataro shav le devlesko. Kako trubul teve la maro attitude. Am I talking to anybody today? This is the attitude we all need to have. If the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Meklepeski Amparitsiano Gayo, Avilomas Karamende, I servisarde amen, con samamete na servis kaver varakas. But serve not for the purpose of being noticed. Serve not for the purpose of getting a badge. Serve not to get the applause of man. Serve to give God the glory, the honor, and the praise. Sazek lak luhok elag buchi kag museum. And his job was to read a cue card, explain what the art was, and step out of the way so the people can see the art. He did this for a few months. He would read the cue card and step out of the way. Did he come to art? Well, after 3-4 months, he got very comfortable anika chabuchi. And what he would do is, he would read the cue card, and instead of move out of the way, did he come to art, my delas duma. Kutsar chi my delas duma pa art, pa pesti delas duma. What school he went to, how many degrees he had, Gonzalez ko papo, Gonzalez ki mami, he would get into a full story about himself. Well, after a few months, he got fired. Fidelis Rigate. You see, church, listen to me very carefully. It's not about you. Our job is to present the art and step out of the way. The people need to see Christ. They need to see the cross. They don't need to see us. Trubulamente, dasam in rigate. Te dicho peo Cristo. Te lo wopes ko barimos. I know everyone has been watching what's going on these past 36 hours, so galope. Po Instagram. Kangara from all over the United States got together and prayed, worshipped, preached the gospel. Thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of prayers and thousands of people. As Badelio del, Acredeo del, Baro revival. And the only thing I've been hearing is this. Which one was the best? Come on. Yes or no? Come on. Which one was the best out of them? Which one had the most followers? Which one you thought was the best? I cannot hampi le jene and then be duma konsas my la shoka taro kaver. Asunen somo taftuka. I'll tell you which one was the best. You want to know? All of them was the best. Every single one of them. Because my body jealous. To nepe manus, te rojimpe, and tute, and the chishere, and the chineporza. To nepe manus to pray for your needs. People that don't even know you, they stood in the gap and they interceded for you. And that's what makes them the best. So give God glory for every one of them. You want to be the best? Be the least. Be the least. And you will be the best in the eyes of God. You see, church, that's what humility is. Is when you pray for others, when you seek the good of others, when you intercede for others. Cachaça e buchi, cataro cristiano. Na ferdi de jasca dela, ferdi amenga. More for me, Lord. Me, 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 me. Codosa bingusco attitude. O cristiano attitude sa savaganga, savaganga, savaganga. Tutti le zobarimos devla. That's what it's about. Number two. Remember where your blessings come from. Remember where your blessings come from. 1 Corinthians 4:7. For what gives you the right to make such a judgment? What do you have that God hasn't given you? And if everything you have is from God, why boast as though it were not a gift? Ekjukal motol. You feed me, you pet me, you care for me, you must be God. A mutza motol, you feed me, you care for me, you pet me, I must be God. Are you listening to this? You have to understand something. No matter what you obtain in this world, I don't care what position you have, I don't care what name you make yourself, understand something. You didn't earn it because you didn't. It was given to you by God, only by His grace. And we should never take honor and take glory for it. All the honor, all the praise, all the glory needs to go to God and God alone. So remember where your blessings come from. It comes from God. Number three. I'm going to end here. Come on, choir. God's love is for everyone. O walimose devlesco sa savaganga. God loves everyone. We would like to think that that's not true. We would like to think that God's love is just for those, the people that we like. The people that we care about. The people that we think is important. But let me tell you something about the love of God. The least, that's the one that God loves. The one that you don't care about, that's the one Jesus died for. The one that you won't give 2 minutes of your time to, that's the one that Jesus wore a crown for. The one that we despise is the one that Jesus' blood was shed for. See, let me tell you something about the love of God. God's love makes everybody on the same field. A level playing field. O volimos de devlesco. Because no matter how good you think you are, no matter how righteous you think you are, you're not good enough in the eyes of God. We are just as guilty as the worst sinner in the eyes of God. And my brothers and sisters, the only reason why you and I today are accepted by God is because of His great love. Not something you could earn, but it was given to us as free grace. And if God loves them, and if God cares for them, who am I not to care for them? And who am I not to love them? Jeremiah 9:23 and 24 says this. This is what the Lord says. Don't let the wise boast in their wisdom, or their powerful boast in their power, or the rich boast in their riches. But those who wish to boast should boast in this alone. Only one thing you can boast about. That they truly know me and understand that I am the Lord who demonstrates unfailing love, who brings justice, righteousness to the earth, and that I delight in these things. I, the Lord, have spoken. I could never boast about my love for God because I fail Him every day. But I'll tell you what I'm going to boast about. His love for me. I can stand here and tell you that God loves me. And that's what I'm going to boast about. And that's what you need to boast about. Pensalalumaka, how much God loves you. Not because you're good, but because He's good. Give Him some glory for that. And church, if we could remember and keep in mind God's love every day of our life, that it's undeserved, that will keep us humble. God gives grace to the humble. And I need all the grace I can get. Amen. Amen.